Can you quickly review with us what James Watson and Francis Crick discovered in the 1950s that would revolutionize molecular biology? And folks, I want you to know that in every one of you, you've got millions of cells, and every one of them have what we've got on the screen right behind you, what we're going to be talking about today. So this concerns you. Stephen?
Well, right. Watson and Crick made a striking discovery in 1953, which is that they were able to elucidate the structure of the DNA molecule. By that time, many scientists were suspecting that DNA had something to do with the transmission of information or hereditary information, and Watson and Crick were able to figure out what DNA, what it looked like, how it was put together, and that suggested that it was an information-carrying molecule. And 5 years later, Francis Crick formulated something known as the sequence hypothesis, and that was the idea that along the spine of the DNA molecule, along the interior of that double helix, there are chemical subunits, and those subunits are known as bases or nucleotide bases. And Crick postulated that those nucleotide bases are functioning like alphabetic characters in a written text, digital characters like zeros and ones in a section of machine code. And chemists today identify those four digital characters in the DNA with the letters A, C, G, and T.
How long can that be?
A typical gene for building roughly one protein is about 1,000 base pairs, or 1,000 of those digital characters. But in our bodies, we have about 3 billion base pairs, or digital characters, the nucleotide bases, that either build for proteins or process and direct the processing of that information. So there's actually a hierarchical arrangement of information in living cells, where you have some information telling other information when to turn on and off.
And the people that are watching, when they look at this thing of DNA, first of all, how many cells do they have in the human body that has one of these DNA molecules in every cell in their body? First of all, how many cells are in their body?
Well, there's trillions of cells in the human body, and every cell has information stored in DNA, which is part of a larger information storage, transmission, and processing system that doesn't just equal our own digital information processing systems that we build in high-tech digital computing. It vastly exceeds it in its storage capacity and sophistication.